So much is expected from the director. The responsibility, the privilege to steer the Bureau into dangerous waters and safely out again. To inspire and lead its people, to protect them. The board is there to advise you, but they want things in return. You hold all this in your old, trembling hands. I had to lose everything before I could see the Bureau is the director's life. There's no room for anything else. If the forces contained here escaped, we'd be dragged back into an age of superstition, terror, death. Assuming you think we ever really left that behind. Any emergency, any major containment breach, and the lockdown goes into effect. I implemented this security measure in my first years as director. I knew we were vulnerable. I'd personally seen the cost of sloppiness. I made sure the internal lockdown could only be lifted by a directorial override, only to be used when the director is confident the sectors are safe to be opened again. This way, the director is the last line of defense. And if I screw up, it's on me. And me alone.
is in pipe C through F. Is the clock back? Now?
Crew feels a lot safer when you're around.
I should be going.
Right. You got a lockdown to lift.
What's your read on this?
Energy conversion's well below the acceptable percentage. The thermal pressure's climbing so fast.
Keeping my eyes open. We ain't out of the woods yet.
Crash, did Ati need barrels full of hazardous biological material? Seems like I'm breaking some environmental regulations on waste disposal, but if that's what Ati wants, then I'll get it done.
Thank you.
That's all of them. A lot of these questions could be answered by obtaining a live specimen.
Here? We don't have the proper facilities.
Maybe we can bring in an observation unit from the containment sector. I'll put in a request with Pope.
Pope has asked us to document the piece.
Jesse, you made it. And you lifted the internal lockdown.
Let's talk, Emily.
Yes, of course.
Listen, Emily.
Screw it. Just tell her.
I haven't been completely honest. I have a younger brother, Dylan. When we were kids, we found an old slide projector in Ordinary's landfill. The slides created doorways to other places. Bad things happened. Came through.
That's all she gets. The rest stays locked inside.
But we found help. Through one of the doorways, we met something. A being.
A being? What kind of being?
It's hard to describe, but it... She helped us. We managed to turn the projector off. The bad things that came through the doorways were gone. After that, your people came. Tried to grab us. I ran away. They got Dylan.
I left him behind.
Bureau agents took your brother?
Yes. No one believed me. I just want to find Dylan. I've been looking for him ever since.
What happened to the slide projector? It sounds like another object of power.
I thought you took it. The Bureau. Along with Dylan.
I've never heard of it. But around here, assume everything's classified. You know, I looked into the Ordinary AWE case files after you mentioned it. Trench and Darling were both involved. A large area of the containment sector was reserved for it. The case hasn't been active for a long time. I have no idea if anything's still there. Can you tell me more about this being you found?
Let's hope you two get along.
She's been with me ever since Ordinary. In my head. She led me to you. I call her Polaris.
As in a guiding star. Did Polaris know about the hiss? If she got you in here, in spite of the lockdown, she's very powerful. Which may help explain your test results. Your readings are incredible, Jesse. Now, cross-referencing them with the database, I found two matches in Darling's old classified files. Unfortunately, I can't access them beyond the file codes, but one was P6, referring to a prime candidate for a potential future bureau director. This was logged years ago.
Dylan. Is that Dylan?
The other match is on something called Hedron, which must be connected to these Hedron Resonance amplifiers somehow. All I know is that Marshall went to the research sector to secure the HRA production after the HIS first attacked.
So, Marshall seems like our best lead on Dylan.
I need to go after her. How can I get to the research sector?
Use my keycard. The sector elevator will take you there.
Marshall is the next step. What Emily told me about Ordinary, my powers being connected to things in the Bureau's past, I am so close to something. Do you feel it? Something's coming.
We take turns to come for a visit. I helped you. You owe me now. And when time comes, I will come calling.
Hi, Jesse. I keep finding traces of Darling, but still can't find him. Where could he be?
He's usually in his office in research, or one of his labs. Dr. Darling has quite a few, all around the Bureau. Could be hiding in any one of them. I check myself, but I don't have access to most of them.
Sounds like I touched a nerve.
He didn't let you into his labs?
Not all of them, no. Some had volatile material. That's ridiculous. I mean, this whole place is volatile material. Could have at least thought of a more convincing lie. I mean, how can I work without access to all the data possible?
This place has a bad habit of moving around, huh?
So you noticed the building shifts. Did you know that 39% of Bureau accidents are caused by the shifts? It's true. I ran the numbers myself.
So they're dangerous.
Oh, very. Yet one time, a shark got shifted into a meeting room along with over 2,000 gallons of water. It was a tiger shark. Darling's pet research project. I forget what he was researching.
How do people work here?
You said you're an assistant?
Oh, it's just a title. I'm a scientist, a researcher. I work for Dr. Darling. See, when Bureau agents go out in the field, the sites of altered world events, we study the materials, the altered items they bring back. It's always something we've never seen before, and studying them requires new instruments, methodologies, sometimes entirely new fields of science.
Emily really loves her job.
See, there's no guidebook for what we do here. Everything that happens at the Bureau, including the science, is without precedent.
What exactly is the Ocean View Motel?
That's a bigger question than you might think. You see, I have extreme doubts that the motel is a single place. I mean, look at all the doors inside it. Where do they all go? We know that one door leads to the oldest house, but how come we can only ever open that one door? Maybe to open a door, you have to have entered through it. So if every door leads to a different dimension, plane, reality, whatever you want to call it, then I believe that the motel is firm proof that parallel universes exist.
Does Darling agree with that?
I haven't told him yet. I'm waiting until I can prove it.
What can you tell me about control points?
They're nexus points of the oldest house's unique energies. Well, I wrote a 30-page proposal hypothesizing that we could siphon energy directly from them. Darling didn't even get through the first page before he turned it down.
Right. And, has anyone ever used them to teleport around?
No. What, I mean, you mean physically? No, not that I've ever heard of. Why?
Because that's how they work for me.
What? Really? Oh my god. More tests.
Let's hold off on the tests until later, okay?
Okay. It's just... wow. This blows my control point theories right out of the water. I love it.
See you soon.
Be careful out there.
Thank you. I saw Trench and Darling arguing a couple weeks ago. Trench was furious. You don't think Darling...
Don't be stupid. What would the... Bureau's golden child had to gain from killing the boss.
If the internal lockdown is in effect, then they can't use the elevator.
Thank you.
I heard that this attack the power plant brings up a lot of new questions. Are we communicating? Coordinating? What about the...
Research sector is the worst. Doctors don't know how to clean after themselves. Dumbo.
Dr. Faden.
What's your read on this?
Energy conversion's well below the acceptable percentage. Internal pressure's climbing so fast on the main. Please go home. When it blows, we're all going.
Control. I'm Dr. Casper Darling, head of research. Somebody thought this video would make for great internal communications. I'm looking at you, Mr. Tomasi. So, this is where the magic happens. Anyway, I've been here for 24 years now. I've always been here. And through those years, we've made astonishing discoveries, authored studies of grave importance, and in all this work, there is one thing we know, and that's how little we truly know. Rest assured, we're committed to keep pushing the known laws and borders of reality, and to make the Bureau proud. So, welcome. Assuming you have the necessary clearance, and do follow the safety protocols. Read the manual. Otherwise, bad things will happen.
Research sector, huh? Home of the Bureau's mad scientists. She's in trouble. I need to reach her.
Thank you.
most important... Information on the astral plane is classified, but we can talk in broad strokes, keeping in mind that these are staggeringly complex systems, and simplification does them no justice. Now, the white non-space, the ever-present inverted black pyramid, the wood, all linked, intrinsically tied to the oldest house, tied to the director, the process of choosing a director, tied to all objects of power in terms of who controls them. Yes. An early hypothesis was that the mindscape of the astral plane is subjective. But that was fast proven wrong. It's an actual place, not a construct of the mind, even though it is with our minds that we enter and experience it. But then one could argue that that's the case with all reality. We've been able to record footage of the astral plane by monitoring the brain activity of those experiencing it. That is the only concrete material that has come out of the astral plane expeditions. Apart from one shocking exception. In the astral plane footage, we're always in the vicinity of the pyramid. We've concluded that this, not the entire plane, is what the board controls. We have glimpsed movement, native species, always in the distance, and yet, contact was made. We don't have footage of this, a technical malfunction, but when one of our astronauts returned, a brain cloud, an astral fugue, had hitchhiked a ride in his head. It ruptured out, killing the subject in question. It's a relentless predator, pursuing thoughts, minds, lethal to those the entity feeds on. Proper containment protocols are to be observed when dealing with it.
They keep that thing here. Thank you. Bureau doing with that thing?
Someone answer, damn it! We need backup down here!
Marshall, are you still there?
Shit. We're so close. We need to hurry.
Thank you.
see it. Another object of power? They're just standing there, mesmerized by it.
Thank you.
Marshall, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Who is this?
My name is Jesse Faden. I'm coming to help.
Faden? Hold on. I'm setting the elevator for you. We need a talk.
She got that right.
More of you? Really?
Marshall is waiting for you in the luck lab, just down the hall.
To the party, ma'am. Marshall is right down the hall.